Good morning.
Morning.
Late? I am never late. Did you see this morning? Did you look outside? Did you see the frost on the ground? Did you see the steam coming off the tanks? And how quiet and still the air was? How quiet it was? Of course, I got worried this morning. But that was peace. I could just feel peace. It was just beautiful. And that's what we're celebrating today. We're celebrating peace.
Amen.
That thing that is sometimes so hard to find until we talk with God, until we let God in. Amen.
Amen.
So let's stand, let's sing. Let us worship his name and thank him for all he has done for us.
Joy to all you.
today, after church, don't forget to stay. Our junior high and high school kids, they've worked hard on this little play they're putting on for y'all. 10, 15 minutes, right, for the play. But we have snacks and finger foods and cookies down there. Y'all come down and support the kids. Show them we are appreciative of what they're doing. All right. Tomorrow morning, we have our breakfast from 8 to 10. Made-to-order breakfast, so y'all come and enjoy that. Wednesday is next, right? There we go. Wednesday, we'll wrap up our Advent study, so we'll be here from 6 to 7:30, closing that out. And then the play, that's today. There we go. Monday, finance meeting at 6:30, so finance tomorrow night, 6:30, ad board, 7 o'clock. Christmas Eve. Y'all coming on Christmas Eve? It's my favorite service of the year. My favorite, because we get to play with fire. It's my favorite, right? Y'all didn't like that? Y'all don't want to play with fire? Fireman feels like
fire.
Yes, of course. Okay, so we have to do a few things. We have to tend to business. Was that it? Our second giving. Do y'all know what our second giving is?
Yes.
So for the past few years, the church has come together. Y'all tell me, from y'all's mouth, what are some of the ministries we do to help people?
Jam.
Jam, that's right. Change for change, where we build ramps.
Operation
Christmas Child.
Wednesday Church,
that's the best, isn't it?
We typically raise money for Vacation Bible School.
Money for Vacation Bible School. When we raise money there, it goes to the fire department. It goes to Panther Angels. Y'all's money that y'all put toward that. Miss Lauren and several folks went out and gathered stuff, and we bought Christmas. Not we. The money everybody donated bought Christmas for 12. Miss Lauren, how many kids did you go out and shop for? 12 kids are going to have Christmas. Look at that, guys. That's a ministry. That's amazing. What else? Y'all know anything else?
Giving people presents.
Giving people presents. That's important, isn't it? When little kids don't understand, right? So that's what the second giving is all about, is making sure that we can keep doing those ministries. And at Christmas time, we always come together and we do what's called a second giving, where people pay their offering, give their offering to God, but then they come and give over and beyond to help us in the next year ministry. So that's what the second giving is. Okay, we have to do a couple of things. First, we have to talk about our candles that we're going to light. And I lost my candle. Okay, do y'all remember the first week? What was our first word?
Hope.
What is hope? What did we say hope was? That something's going to get better, right? Something better is coming. So we light our hope candle. What was our candle we lit the next week?
Joy.
What is joy?
Like happiness.
Happiness, right? Joy in our soul that no matter what's going on, knowing God is there. And we talked about Mary, remember? The joy when Mary said yes to God, right? And then this week, what is our candle?
Peace.
What is peace? Everything's okay. That's a good answer. Oh,
your candle.
Candle out. Peace and quiet. That's what almost every jam kid said when we asked them what peace was. They said peace and quiet. And that's about right. Peace. Peace in our soul. Peace that God gives us in our heart. That no matter what's going on, we can be angry. We can be sad. We can be happy. We can be cranky. We can be grinchy. Remember we did the Grinch 2 weeks ago? We can be grinchy. God still loves us, right? And God still loves us. We can be crazy. Are you ever crazy? I can't imagine. I cannot imagine. Okay, so a few weeks ago, we handed out little Grinch candies, and what did we tell everybody?
Don't be a Grinch.
Don't be a Grinch this season, right? Don't complain. And then last week, what happened? Somebody complained. Then we called them Grinches, and so we had to give them sweet candy, right, and tell them God loves you. So we gave them peppermint candy last week. This week, I have candy for them that hopefully they'll like. So you get to go pass it out and make sure everybody here gets one. And this is mint truffle candy. Maybe they'll like this one, okay? All right, so everybody go give everybody two pieces of candy. And then we're going to come back and pray before y'all get your candy, okay? Okay? Go make sure everybody gets one and then come back, okay? Go make sure everybody gets one. And remember, every now and then, y'all have to look at the camera and wave to people, okay? People like Miss Edwina and Mr. Bruce and Ms. Margaret, people like that that are watching us, and all of our friends, every now and then they just want to see y'all smiling faces. Yes, yes. We'll do that in a little bit. Okay, there we go. Okay. All right, adults, you'll have to help them. If you haven't gotten one, raise your hand so they know who to give one to, okay? Okay? Who, have y'all already been out once? Let's see who needs one. Who? Can you? You have not been out? There you go. You haven't been out? Okay? All right, raise your hand if you have not gotten a piece of candy. Oh, there's Miss Linda. Okay, they're getting them. Who else? Anybody else? Oh, look right there. Miss Debbie, Miss Shirley. Who else? Who else? Who else? Oh, very good. We're gonna do that again. Very good. Alright. Anybody else? Alright. So what I have for you guys, because y'all had your party this morning, right? Our kiddos had birthday party for Jesus today. And what did y'all have? Cupcakes. So you didn't have any cookies. So we decided y'all needed sugar cookie kisses, right? Okay, because they're the best. Okay, but first we have to pray. We have to pray for our day. We have to pray for our offering. And then we have a very special treat. Miss Betsy's class is all learning the Lord's Prayer. And so today, Daylin is going to lead us in the Lord's Prayer. And everyone will join with her, okay? All right, so I'll pray. We'll pray, and then you close us out with the Lord's Prayer, okay? You might need to be by a microphone. You're going to be by a microphone? Okay, hop up there by this camera. All right? Okay, let's pray. Dear God, we thank you so much for this day, for each and every child and adult that is here, those that are watching online. God, we just thank you that those that have listened to the Holy Spirit tune their heart into worship today, God. So lead us through this day. Tune our hearts into your voice, God. Give us a peace that shuts out all of the distractions of the world and helps us to focus directly on you. Let the offerings given here today or online be multiplied to benefit your kingdom and all of the ministries you have called this body to.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. That thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Amen. All right, here y'all
been journeying with us the last few weeks through Advent, you know that our decor this year is kind of like last year, just a little simple. We have a few added elements, but a little smaller or simpler. I had someone ask me a couple weeks ago online if exactly what they see here is what we have. It is. Everything we have decorated is here. Usually we have things up on the balcony, and this year we just literally kept it simple to remind us that we're journeying toward the manger. So that's where we wanted everybody's focus to be. So, of course, our theme has been simply Christmas. I want to remind you that Advent's not just an extension of Christmas. It is a season all its own. It's a season that takes us from the past to the present to the future. And so I want you to hear our scripture today from the past that we celebrate in the present and takes us to the future. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests on his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. This is the word of God for you, the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Let's pray. Holy and gracious God, we thank you for your presence here today. Prince of Peace, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God. In this time, God, may we focus on nothing but your voice. Your voice through music, your voice through prayer, your voice through children, your voice through each and every person here. God, remove the outside world. Remove it all, God, and put us in your heavy presence as we listen for your interaction today. We ask all this in Christ's name. Amen. Amen. As you heard from the Old Testament, this is where the part that we celebrate the past is when it's the promise of the coming Messiah, which leads us to the present today of where we celebrate his birth and on into the future of the second coming of the King, when he will come back and take all of his children home. And so we live in hopeful anticipation of that. We use the words during Advent, the hope, the joy, the peace, and next week the love. Those are all affirmations of what God is in our lives, and they lead us. We sit in those hopeful affirmations of what is to come, the joy that is to come. We claim that as we speak during Holy Communion last week, and we said the mystery of faith is that Christ has died, Christ has risen, and Christ will come again, past, present, and future. We wait in active and assured and a hopeful waiting. And so as we focus on those different attributes today, I want you to keep in mind that simple Christmas as we look at this. Because the ones that you would not have thought would have been embodied in the message of peace would have been the shepherds. But I want you to hear from Luke 2 today as we hear about our friends, the shepherds. Luke 2. In that region, there were shepherds living in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those whom he favors." Two things I want to pick out of this from the very beginning. I want you to hear what it says. It says, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy." It doesn't stop. Does it say I'm bringing you great news of joy? It says I'm bringing great news of joy for all the people. This is for you too. This is for you, great news of joy. Then it goes on and it says a heavenly host of angels joined in. Now, y'all, can you even begin to imagine what was going on? As these lowly shepherds, people who no one paid any attention to, people that stunk, people that were outcasts on the outside of town, sitting in a field somewhere in the middle of dark Israel, and they got the birth announcement of a king. It didn't go to the kingdom. It didn't go to the prophets. It didn't go to the Pharisees. It didn't go to the scribes. It went to the stinky shepherds, y'all. Amen. You think about having your children, and these days they engrave the birth announcements. Y'all know how that goes. They engrave the birth announcements. They put it on Facebook. They send it out telling everybody that the child has been born. And they send it to the people who are going to do
what? Bring them gifts, right? That's not who God sent it to. That's not who God sent the birth announcement of the king to. He sent it to these shepherds sitting in the middle of a dark field. So you can imagine the silence as they try to ward off the dangers that would attack their sheep. So they're sitting out there listening for all of the dangerous animals that might come against them, listening for other shepherds who want to come kill them and steal their flock. They're listening in the silence when all of a sudden this angel rings out to tell them about a birth of a child. I would have fainted, right? I think that's what they mean by sorely afraid, right? But not just one, not just one. It says the multitude of angels. Another translation of the Bible says heaven's army. Another one says angel army. So this angel army comes to the shepherds to proclaim the birth of a king. Y'all, if God will send angels to lowly, stinky, poor shepherds, I think he'll send them to me too. God is showing us in this that he will not only use a humble servant like a shepherd, but he might use us too, right?
Yes.
I think there's some things we can learn from the shepherds, these everyday night shift working people that might just be biblical. I want you to think back to the shepherds that were already in the Bible. The patriarchs of Israel, Abraham, the first person God laid out a covenant with was a shepherd. So were his descendants, Isaac and Jacob. They were all shepherds too. And the greatest king of all time, David, started out as a young shepherd boy. I think that pulls us back to remind us that God will use the people who the world thinks is nothing special. God will use those who may be humble, who have no pride, who have no worth in themselves. That's who God will use. God will use the everyday person. It wasn't the most holy people or those who were thought to be the most holy that ended up kneeling at the manger. It was the humble shepherds who knelt at the manger. These humble shepherds who followed this child to the manger, right? So I want you to know today as we talk about this, where you're going to find God. You're going to find God in the middle of where you are, okay? Because that's where God was. As this young boy and girl, you can't even call them a man and a woman, these young teenagers, as they travel across 95 miles on foot to go be counted in a census, this unwed mother, right? They travel as they're trying to explain to people how all this came to be, right? They travel to go be counted in this census. They get there. They have this child, and God is in the middle the whole time. As these shepherds travel to see this baby, God is in the middle of that dark field until they get to that manger. And then there lies the face of God that they get to see. That's who got to get the announcement of the birth, right? These shepherds, also biblical, that took care of sheep, of lambs, which turned out to be the sacrificial animal, right? That they would take to temple to slaughter on behalf of the people, to rid them of their sins, to make this sacrifice to God. God chose people who took care of a sacrificial animal to go see his son, the sacrifice, for the first time. That's biblical, y'all. That's biblical that this is who God used to identify with his son. I think if these lowly shepherds can identify, so can we, right? I think this tells us that peace is not based on who you are. Peace is not based on your social status. Peace is not based on your job. Peace is not based on how much money you have. Peace is based on you listening for great news of great joy.
Amen.
That's what peace is based on, knowing that God sends good news of great joy for all people.
Yes.
Not just you can be holy or hoodie, right?
Mm-hmm.
Either one. But God is going to send you peace in the midst of it all.
Yes.
So I asked the first group, we're 13 days away from Christmas. And I wonder how your season's going. Because usually, we say PC, we have BC and PC, before Christ and pre-pandemic, pre-COVID, right? So pre-COVID, you would ask somebody how their season's going. And typically you would get, I'm so busy, or it's so hectic, or there's not enough time in the day, or... So five specific people I asked this week, how their season was going. And I got the words, I'm lonely,
We're all looking for peace, some of us just for this holiday season, some of us to carry us into the next season. Some of us are facing things that it's unimaginable that we should have to face, right? But here's what I know. In the midst of whatever you're facing, God shows up in the middle of it.
Amen.
God shows up in the middle of whatever it is. That's where God appeared in that dark Israel field. Was right smack dab in the middle of the mess.
Yes.
Right? In the middle of the messy field. In the middle of the mess of unwed parents. In the middle of the mess of the Holy Spirit saying they were going to be the father of the child. The whole mess of it all. And God was right in the middle.
Yes.
That's where we find God is right with us. Peace sometimes sounds like a long way off. And there are things that threaten our peace. Right? So I tell you today that the scripture says that it is the peace of God that passes all understanding that will guard your hearts and your minds. Sometimes we can't ward off those circumstances. But what we can ward off is the devil laying more worry on our hearts. Right? Because God says, I'm going to walk with you smack dab in the middle of it. I'm going to be there with you, and I'm going to walk right through it. Now, I know that somebody could say to me right now, Pastor, you have no idea. No, I don't, but I know who walks with you. That's what I do know. I do know who walks with you. And I know the scripture says this, for he himself is our peace. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. And to his government there will be no end. Now you got to walk in that for a minute. No end. That means whatever you face, there is no end to God's peace that can be on your life. Right? No peace. I told them also first service that I got a phone call yesterday morning about 7 o'clock from a friend of mine that I've been friends with for so long, and her husband is taking his last steps in this earth. And she called and wanted to know if I would come say a prayer over him. And as I walked in, it was just such a peace in that room. Such an everlasting peace. And she said he has followed God his entire life, and he knows where he's going, so he's at peace.
Amen.
That's peace that knows no end, right? I got a call last night from a friend of mine that we've known since my kids were little, way little, and her husband died unexpectedly yesterday. And she said, I'm heartsick, but I'm at peace.
Amen.
I don't know where the peace comes from. I don't know where the peace comes from. Just know I have peace. And she said, I'm so confused about it because I don't know where this peace comes from. I talked to somebody else this past week that is just dealing with some heavy, heavy stuff. And she said, you've dealt with heavy stuff, and I don't know how you do it. And I said, well, I have not dealt with what you're dealing with. And so I had to think about what my biggest struggle is right now. And so for 2 weeks, I've struggled with the fact that I have seen all of my grandchildren born. And I won't get to see my granddaughter born this week because of the pandemic, and they still haven't lifted restrictions. So I won't get to see that grandchild born, and that has just weighed on me. Some of you grandparents have never gotten to see that, and I understand that is just the greatest gift my daughter has given me ever. And so I've just been down this week because I'm not going to get to see that. But I remember that God is in the middle of it all.
Amen.
God is there no matter what. Hear this scripture. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I'm gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. This is the invitation this Advent season. I just want you to close your eyes. I want you to just close your eyes and hear these words again. Let them wash over you. Not my voice. God, come to me, all who are struggling hard, all who are carrying heavy loads, you who struggle with loneliness, you who struggle with sickness, you who struggle with grief and hardships, depression, family, you who struggle with life, come to me, and I will give you peace. Gracious God, may we be encouraged in this Advent season to look for the Prince of Peace. Even when the winds blow and the storms swirl, help us to worship like the shepherds. Even when we find ourselves in the darkest field or in a storm, remind us to come to you because you're here. The Prince of Peace is with us in the middle of it all. And we are so grateful. We ask, gracious God, that you would guard our hearts and our souls and our minds. Shower your peace upon us, filling us with your spirit of wholeness and ruling as the Prince of Peace in our hearts. We ask all this in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
We added another tree this week because I just felt like, as I was talking to my friend this week, all three of them, I said, you know, we share our testimonies, we share when God does something good, and sometimes we forget to share with people that we do have burdens, and that we do have struggles, and where we get that peace from. So during the last song, if you feel led, if you will come to hang a bow, or place a ball upon the tree to show others that while you have struggles, you know who the Prince of Peace is.
Thank you.
welcome a vote for service for those watching online, some of our shut-ins, some of our folks that we know are facing such hard times. So I hang one for those folks now and lift prayers for them.
Amen.
Go from this day in peace knowing that the God of the universe loves you and holds you in his arms. Go in peace.